Gosh, you ever just really want to get classic sometimes?
Or you want to just drive down the road and get super classic?
So classic!
No way. How awesome.
Now, man, let's get on the road and let's get classic!
From San Diego, where literally like stickers on your board meant you're not catching waves, you know? Like you go out there with all that shit, you're not gonna get anything. And if anything, people are gonna look down on you because it's a working class town, you know? And really, when you're a professional surfer, you're the most spoiled, rotten person on the planet. And anybody who complains about their job that surfs is a bitch. I had people like Nat Young and Takayama and Herbie Fletcher, you know, Skip Emblem from SMA, Fausto Vitello from Thrasher, David Nueva, Jerry Lopez, and all these people who kind of orchestrated and guided me and gave me a second family unit, you know what I mean? And now that I have kids and I can share all this stuff that I got from everybody else, it's like the ultimate payback. And my kids, my son's now surfing, he's skating, I've got him doing jiu-jitsu, you know? I'm not doing it so that my kid gets a sponsor, you know what I mean? I'm doing it because I want him to enjoy the same stuff I had as a kid. I had a really fortunate life, and hopefully, you know, through surfing and other stuff, he can do the same. If not, you can go pound nails with my brother. I don't give a shit. I still love my kids.
You know. This me. This yippee.
So I met Nathan in, I think, I want to say like 88 or 87. There's so much stuff about Nate that people don't know, and this is such an era of self-promotion with their blogs and all this other crap, check me out and do this, and it's like, Nate is so removed from all that and so in his own planet, and everything that he does, he doesn't do it for attention to himself, he does it because it's a personal challenge. In a sea of bland, Nathan stands out.
Oh my God.
Oh. Growing up in San Clemente was insane to be able to skateboard and surf and do all the things that you get to do, but definitely was influenced by, you know, my uncles and my grandpa and my dad, brother. More or less who I'd want to surf like would be like Dane or Marvin, definitely Tom Carroll, any of those people. Definitely influenced by the way they their approach in the waves. I like Central America. You could definitely figure out how to surf good waves or some, you know, pretty quality waves without all the people. It's super rewarding and then super challenging. It's just much more challenging than rewarding, so it's good.
Oh!
my whole life was made pretty much from Tahiti. And so I guess I have a spiritual connection or special connection. It's the master vortex, you know. It's like everything boils down to Chopo, pretty much. To see John, what he's doing right now, it's pretty funny because I guess I could remember being his age, and to see how much he's progressed is pretty trippy. And to see all, like, Nathan, Ivan, it's like they weren't even humans. And now it's like they're people I have to answer to. Like, they're my elders, you know.
Nearly is a wedge.
Look at that. Look at, oh my god.
A wedge is all up and down the beach.
Check it out. Yes.
Don't light me up. I got a sharp fuse. Don't pump me down. I just love the dirt. Tie me up because I'll just get loose. You try to play, you might get hurt. The violence in your confusion. Just like the blood from the working dead.
Yeah.
today was about as sick as you could order ever, ever in the millennium. You surfed ours for the first time.
One of the best days of surfing possibly I've ever had. Sick vibes, sick waves, just cool people, and some beatings to go with them, so it's sick. Super fun.
That's so much fun out there. I'm like, I just am depleted of froth. I froth so hard out there. Those guys are absolute freaks, man. Fuck, that was just unbelievable. That was my favorite day of surfing, like, maybe ever. I was so sick out there.
Power of the ultraviolet sun.
Being raised in Hawaii is pretty much the sickest thing ever. Like, I love it in Hawaii. I'd never want to move away or anything. Growing up there, it's like, you know, everyone's pretty much a family. Where I live on North Shore, everyone knows each other. You're all buddies. It's just really good vibes and stuff. I remember back when we were little, we used to just have beach days all day long, go down with a blanket and umbrella and just sit at the beach all day long, surfing nonstop. Come in, eat peanut butter and jelly, I was already down there. Pretty much all day from like 7 in the morning to just 7 at night, and then it gets dark, and I just go home, and next day, same thing again.
Have a good time.
Yeah, it was a good time.
We'll be right back.
pretty much, if it's like those other people I said are my influences from when I was young, and then like John and Dane, those would be my influences from this day and age. Dane's gnarly. He actually makes me stoked on pro surfing, and to see somebody like that and be involved in the top of the top.
Get in the road, let's get classic. Whoa, dude, last night got weird.
And classic.
Classic.
One, two, three, four.
Down the road, getting classic. Oh, nothing but the clothes on my back. Driving down the road, getting classic. Just got a fresh six pack. Slapped in the face, I got denied. I'll be back for another try. Are you keen for this? Let's get out of here. Driving down the road, getting classic. Shit, my pants all wet.
Oh, man.
Driving down the road, getting classic. On the neck as you go down.
Now there's room for two in my sleeping bag. Oh no, I got a duty.
Driving down the road, getting classic. Nothing but an old fair road. Driving down the road, getting classic. That's how the story goes.
Oh, yeah!
Get out of here.
That was good.